You've heard of the deadly nightshade, right? It's one of the world's most poisonous plants. But do you know you probably eat some of its relatives every day? There are about 2,300 species of flowering plants in the nightshade family, including mandrake and deadly nightshade. Well, the name's right there. Kind of a dead giveaway. Also known as belladonna, the deadly nightshade has foliage and berries that are extremely toxic. Eating 2 berries can kill a child, and eating just 10 can kill an adult. Mandrake, or mandragora, is a powerful narcotic and hallucinogen. Also known as Satan's apple, the root of this deadly plant looks like a human body. That made it an important part of Mediterranean myth and legend. But not all nightshade plants are deadly. Stay tuned as we reveal some of your favorites from this dangerous family. Number 5. Goji berries. These brightly colored berries contain lots of vitamin C and antioxidants. The Chinese have enjoyed them for more than 2,000 years, and traditional Chinese medicine uses them to boost liver and kidney function. Modern science has discovered that these berries have other health benefits, including protecting against cancer, promoting healthy skin, and stabilizing blood sugar. They also reduce depression, anxiety, and insomnia. Number 4. Peppers. Peppers, including bell and chili peppers, are also part of the nightshade family. They contain high amounts of vitamin C, which helps your body absorb iron. For at least 9,000 years, Native American, Chinese, Japanese, and Indian healers have used the capsaicin in chili peppers for medicinal purposes. Number 3. Potatoes. When Spanish explorers first introduced Europeans to potatoes in the 1600s, they thought the tubers were poisonous and did not eat them. When Europeans did start enjoying them, they had a huge impact. Within 100 years, the population of Northern Europe doubled. But all parts of the potato plant are not safe to eat. Only the underground tuber portion of the plant, the part we think of as the potato, is safe. All green parts of the potato plant and the fruit contain high amounts of solanine. It's one of the poisonous alkaloids common in nightshade plants. This nerve toxin can cause vomiting, paralysis, and death. But don't worry too much if your potato skin has some green on it, as that's not solanine. It's chlorophyll. The tubers make it when they're exposed to sunlight. So, carry on. Number 2, eggplants. Is eggplant on your list of favorite vegetables? Well, you'll need to change that list. Eggplants aren't vegetables. They're berries. But that hasn't stopped some people from referring to it as the king of vegetables. People in India were the first to eat eggplant, but researchers discovered this nightshade family member originated in the savannas of Africa. An average raw eggplant contains about 11 milligrams of solanine. But eating a couple of raw eggplants isn't dangerous. It would take about 400 milligrams to threaten an average adult's life. About 36 raw eggplants contain that much solanine. So, might want to take a few off your plate. And number 1, tomato. Europeans once considered tomatoes poisonous, as they resemble other nightshade vegetables. But like eggplant, the tomato is a fruit, not a vegetable. At one time, people called tomatoes the poison apple, as wealthy aristocrats seemed to get sick and die after eating them. But it turns out they were poisoned by the lead the acidic tomatoes leached from pewter plates. Tomatoes are a fantastic source of vitamins, minerals, and fiber. Research has shown that eating 2 or more servings of tomato a week can reduce a man's chance of developing prostate cancer. If you find that eating any of these foods causes inflammation, psoriasis, or inflammatory bowel disease, you may have an allergy or sensitivity to nightshade foods. Although these 5 foods are related to deadly nightshade, they are delicious parts of our modern diets.
Wow.
But have you ever wondered what plants kick-started agriculture? We'll look at 8 of them on another episode of Origins of Food.